Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In a previous video, I demonstrated a new capability in version 12 to validate a JSON message using JSON schema. In this video, I will demonstrate how you can configure the failure action so that when validation fails, different actions are taken by App Connect Enterprise. So here I have a simple message flow. It just has HTTP input and reply. It takes a JSON message and echoes it back. The HTTP input node is configured for validation, has content and value specified. And on the input message parsing tab, it is specifying a JSON schema, which models the message, which will be processed by the flow. The JSON schema describes that the message will contain an object, which has three properties, which are ID, which is of type integer, name, which is of type string, and price, which is of type number. On the HTTP input node, in the validation tab, there is a node property called failure action, and this is used to describe what action App Connect Enterprise should take when a validation error occurs. So at the moment, it is set to exception, and I will take you through what happens when you select the different options. So we'll start with exception. And I can send the messages using the flow exerciser or Postman or curl. There's different ways of sending the JSON messages to the flow. In this video, I'm going to simply use curl. So I'm going to deploy the application which contains the message flow to my integration server. So that's deployed. And I'm going to send this curl message. So this is a message which correctly satisfies the schema. So it has an ID, which is an integer, a name, which is a string, and a price, which is a number. So when we send this message through, it will be echoed back with no validation errors have occurred. So let's try causing a validation error to occur. And let's specify a message which would cause an error. So here I have ID, which is this time a string, but actually it should be an integer. I've specified names, which doesn't exist in the schema, and we have price, which is -2.99. So at the moment, I have exception specified on the failure action, and when I send this message through, I get this exception sent back. So I can see it stops at the first exception, and in this exception, it says that the property has a string, but it was expecting an integer for the property ID. And the definition is in the schema at the location root slash property slash ID. The hash character means root. So if we go back to the schema and have a look at root slash properties slash ID, we can see that it should be expecting integer. So that was with exception. And if we now change the failure action to be exception list, we will see that all of the exceptions will be shown in the error that is returned. So if I save that and redeploy, it's deployed. And now if I send that same invalid message through, we can see that there are further errors returned. So here in the first time when I sent it, when exception was used, it's had a single BIP5751E parsing error. This time there are four. So the first one is for the fact that the property was a string and not an integer, the ID property. The second one is that names has been specified, but names is not an allowed property. Third one is saying that the minimum value of the price property is zero, but it's received -2.99. And the fourth error is saying that a required property is name, but name was not received. So you can see all four errors here shown when exception list is used. Let's have a look at a different failure action. So let's this time choose local error log and save that. So now when I send in the message and the failure action is set to local error log, the message goes through the flow and it is echoed back, but the exceptions are logged in the syslog. So for the integration server, you can see this in the events.txt file. And if I scroll to the bottom, you can see the four BIP 5751E errors are shown in the error log. So you may want to use this option if you want to enable validation, but you want the message to go all the way through the flow and you don't want it to throw an error straight away. So let's have a look at the last option for failure action, which is user trace. So I can select user trace, and in order to use user trace, I'll need to start user trace. So let's start it. I can start the user trace through the toolkit now. So that's started. And now let's redeploy the flow of the application. So the application that's been deployed. And now let's send in the message again. So I've sent in the message, and as before, it's gone all the way through the flow, so it has been echoed back. But the error messages will be captured in the user trace. So if I just refresh the test server, if I go into the config/log directory, I can see the user trace file there. And if I search for BIP 5751E, I can see that have both been logged to the user trace. So there are the four different ways of specifying the failure action. So just to recap, I have described in this video the different ways of configuring the failure action when the JSON message is validated using a JSON schema. You can select from user trace, local error log, exception, or exception list.